Hello again, guys. Super fast and kind of weird video for you today. I bought a new hat, and I thought you might be interested in knowing more about it. When I make my quadcopter and RC type videos when I'm out and about shooting things, I generally have my action camera mounted to this. This is a strap that you have to put on your head. It ends up leaving an impression on your forehead. It's super awkward, but it gets the job done. It has a GoPro mount on it. What if I told you it could be done a little bit less awkwardly, more comfortably? Well, today we're going to be taking a look at the Smatree Smahat H1. Baseball hat for GoPro. I actually reviewed a Smatree product before. They gave me the opportunity to take a look at whatever I wanted, and I asked about this hat and ended up getting the battery base for the Amazon Echo. Not sure how that worked out. So I actually went out of pocket and just bought this. So taking a look inside of the box, just to dive into it, here is the hat. It's a hat. Very much a hat. It's a black hat, which I normally would not go for, but that's not really the point. It's a hat, got a little adjustment here on the back, with a sewn-in GoPro adapter. So this is actually connected to the hat. It's not sticky, it's sewn in there. This is one of the things I was not sure of whenever I purchased the hat, so I wanted to make sure to mention it in case you're curious and in case you're interested. So as you can see here on the inside, there's stitching all the way around this mount, all the way through to the other side, and the stitching looks okay. I'm not a professional in any way, and it's not on there 100% perfectly straight. If you look at the seam here, this line doesn't exactly line up, but it's close enough for what it is. I had already gone ahead and pulled this off and just decided I probably ought to just go ahead and make a quick video about this. But also included in the package, just to make this a little more useful, you have a GoPro mount. It's actually a Smatree branded GoPro mount, and a little pin you're going to need to go ahead and put it in there. So just like this. And it actually came with a spare nut for it, which you might need. But yeah, at this point, what you do, go ahead and stick your GoPro mount in there, screw it into place, put your camera in there, clip it in there just fine, and now, there you go. You've got a GoPro on a hat. And at this point, there you go. I'm hands-free. I can adjust this as necessary, down, up, whichever way you want it. And it's supposed to be set up in such a way that whenever I hit this record button, and now I think the camera's recording, it beeped funny, but it's supposed to be set up such that this brim is not going to get in the way of what the camera's seeing. I may go ahead and just show you what I'm seeing on the camera while we're doing it. But anyway. So yeah, just taking a look at this, it's definitely a super awkward thing. Don't get me wrong, this is the most awkward hat I've ever worn, aside from maybe the hat that I fashioned that was almost identical to this, except it didn't have this little pad. I actually put a tripod mount into the bill of a hat, which made it super awkward. This is a lot less awkward in terms of weight distribution, and I kind of like that. I am curious to see, however, how the footage is... Boy, this is awkward looking. Don't get me wrong at all. This is super awkward. But for the kind of videos I'm going to be making with it, it's perfect. Because it allows me to have a comfortable cover for my eyes, for my head, without having to worry about having that big pad mark in my forehead for the rest of the day. So I'm definitely pleased with it for the price that I paid. It was like 17 bucks over on Amazon, and really, most hats that you buy are going to be in the $12 to $15 range at least. So 17 for a hat that has a built-in GoPro mount. The biggest concern that I would have with it is just how strong is that. Pulling on it right now, it's not coming loose. Like, I'm actually putting some force on it and it's not tearing the hat or anything. Over time, wear and tear might wear it down, but I think it's definitely getting the job done. And for 17 bucks, if it tears up sometime down the road, months, years from now, I'll buy another one. So I'll put a link down in the description to where you can find this if you are interested, if you're the kind of person like myself that flies RC quadcopters or Phantom 3s or drives RC cars and whatnot, and you want to be able to film things, or maybe you just want to chase your kids around the yard. This seems like a pretty good option. So thank you guys, as always, for watching. Remember to hit that thumbs up button, smash that thumbs up button if you like this video. It definitely helps me, lets me know what you like on the channel, lets me know what to keep making and what not to. Subscribe to my channel, though, to receive all the videos that I make as soon as they become available. And I will see you again next time from my hat camera. Bye, guys.